This video describes how to connect the position sensor to your SCADAPAC 474 with ReLift RPC and assumes the sensor will be installed by a qualified set of operators on the pump jack. Please review all safety messages in the ReLift rod pump manual before following the connection steps contained in this video. To learn more about the ReLift RPC and SCADAPAC 474 Smart RTU, see the other videos in our series. The ReLift RPC can use a proximity sensor or an inclinometer as a position sensor. We'll start with the proximity sensor. A proximity sensor generates one signal for each rod pump stroke to indicate the start and end of each stroke cycle to the ReLift RPC. The proximity sensor must be attached to the pump jack such that the proximity sensor is activated by the crank arm but not the counterbalance weights. Check that the proximity sensor is between 8 and 16 millimeters away from the crank arm. The tight clearance between the sensor and the crank arm helps to provide the optimal possible signal when the crank arm passes the sensor. You may want to use additional hardware to mount the proximity sensor closer to the crank arm. When the proximity sensor is installed, run the proximity sensor cable from the sensor to the panel or enclosure containing the ReLift RPC. Route the cable such that the cable will not be able to snag, catch, or pinch on moving equipment. Secure the cable to the pump jack frame using eye bolts, U-bolts, outdoor-rated cable ties, or similar fasteners. And consider the impact of wind on the cable and check that the cable will not be under strain during the complete stroke motion. Connect the proximity sensor output cable to the following points on the SCADAPAC 474. The sensor's 24-volt wire to plus 24 volts in the panel. The sensor's shield to the ground. The sensor's signal wire to digital input 1. And the sensor's return wire to minus 24 volts. With the sensor connected, verify your wiring and then safely apply power to your ReLift RPC. We'll now verify the sensor's connection to the RPC. Safely start the pump. Run it. Then stop it and apply the brake when the crank arm is positioned opposite the proximity sensor, like the image shown here. From the home screen on the ReLift RPC's HMI, press Config menu. From the Configuration menu, press System Configuration. From the System Configuration menu, press I/O Status. The I/O Status screen will now appear. Here you can view the status of the SCADAPAC 474's I/O. Verify that digital input 1 is high, with the proximity sensor active. Start the pump and then stop it with the crank arm moved away from the proximity sensor. Verify that digital input 1 is now low. We'll now connect an inclinometer. An inclinometer provides a continuing signal measuring the angle of the pump jack's walking beam. This angle corresponds to the position of the pump during the stroke. Check that the inclinometer is installed on the walking beam with its axis of measurement aligned with the walking beam. When the inclinometer is installed on the walking beam, run the sensor cable from the inclinometer to the panel or enclosure containing the ReLift RPC. Route the cable such that the cable will not be able to snag, catch, or pinch on moving equipment. Secure the cable to the pump jack frame using eye bolts, U-bolts, outdoor-rated cable ties, or other similar fasteners, and again, consider the impact of wind on the cable and check that the cable will not be under strain during the complete stroke motion. Connect the inclinometer cable to the following points on the SCADAPAC 474 RTU. The sensor's 24-volt wire to plus 24 volts in the panel. The sensor's shield to the ground. The sensor's signal wire to analog input 4. And the sensor's return wire to minus 24 volts. With the inclinometer connected, verify your wiring and then safely apply power to your ReLift RPC. We'll now verify the sensor's connection to the RPC. Safely start the pump and run it in hand mode. From the home screen on the ReLift RPC's HMI, press Config menu. From the Configuration menu, press System Configuration. From the System Configuration menu, press I/O Status. The I/O Status screen will now appear. Here you can view the status of the SCADAPAC 474's I/O. Verify that AI4 changes value as the pump strokes up and down. We have now connected a position sensor to our RPC. To learn more about the ReLift RPC and SCADAPAC 474 Smart RTU, Access the user documentation on Exchange Shop at Schneider Electric's website.